minimum requirement you should be familiar with, and I am sure all these fundamentals you came across in the subject of engineering mechanics in the first year of engineering. Correct. Now, if you look at the prerequisites of this subject, now we will refresh some basic concepts from your engineering mechanics or applied mechanics subject. I think everybody has studied whatever these points I have mentioned here. This type of load, okay, type of load, I think everybody has studied in the applied mechanics subject. Then free body diagram, that is also studied. Then equations of equilibrium, correct? Equilibrium equation also you have studied. Now we will just refresh these three concepts. Okay, so can you mention, can you tell me the types of loads? You can tell me verbally. So I will unmute all of you. So you can just tell me the types of loads, which loads you have studied in the applied mechanics subject. So you can answer here also. So I have unmuted all of you. So yeah. So in this types of load, I will just mention here. There are basically 3 to 4 types of main 3 to 4 types of loads are there. The first one is, you know this point load. Correct. This point load, which is acting at a single point theoretically. Correct. Suppose that is indicated by this P. The second load, can anybody tell? Where is a fundamental type of this load? Second load is uniformly distributed load. You can call that load as UDL, that is uniformly distributed load. And third fundamental type of load is UVL, UVL, that is uniformly varying load. Correct. So these are three fundamental loads which we are required for our this subject. There are many other type of loads are also there, but to solve the problems as per your syllabus, these are three main type of loads are required. Based on this type of load, you will have to solve some basic problems. Now, if you consider the point load, see here, point load is nothing but what? This load is acting at single point. Suppose this is a beam, and on that beam, suppose this is a single point. At that point, if some load is acting, that is called as point load. Okay. Now, what is UDL? UDL, or it is long form is uniformly distributed load. That load is distributed uniformly throughout the span of the beam. Now suppose this is a beam, right? And the load is distributed uniformly. Now suppose I have shown here some two supports like this. Okay. Correct. So if you see such type of load, that means this load is UDL, uniformly distributed load. Correct. Now here the intensity or load, this load is indicated like this way, either in kilonewton per meter. Suppose the distance or the length of beam is in meter, so the UDL, the load UDL, is indicated like this way, kilonewton per meter. Correct. Now we will see UVL. In uniformly varying load, I will show here. In uniformly varying load, suppose I have this beam, again same beam, by name itself you can see that the load is varying and it is uniformly varying. So I can show like this way. So if you see this kind of load, that is called as uniformly varying load. Again, the intensity is shown like similar way, it is kilonewton per meter, where the length of beam is meter. Okay, these are three fundamental loads based on which we have to solve the problems. Sometimes you will find the situation where the loads are in combination of all of these three or any of these two. Correct. Suppose here, suppose you may find a situation like this also, the simply supported beam. Okay, and in some part you will see UDL, at some point you will see point load. Okay, so this type of combinations also, already you have solved such kind of problems in applied mechanics subject, and you know how to calculate the result, reactions and all those things. Okay, but still just we are seeing here right now the types of loads, then we'll slowly apparently move to the all the points. Now see here, we have seen these main three loads, point load, UDL and UVL. There is another type of load. It's not a basically force, but that is called as moment. Okay. So that force is basically called as moment. So I will mention that fourth number here, that is called as moment. This is also called as type of load which can be act on beams or columns. Okay, so total you will see four types of load, loads which are forces, and one load that is nothing but moment. So again, moment is shown like this symbol, either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction. Okay. Now we have seen all these type of loads and their representations, but while solving some problems, we need to convert all these loads into code. Okay. Suppose if I want to convert UDL into point load. Suppose this UDL, if I want to convert into point load, what I can do? I have to just represent the same beam and point load that will act at the center of the beam, correct? And the quantity of this load that will be, suppose here the intensity is, suppose its intensity is W kilonewton per meter. So here the load, total load will be capital W. Okay, so this capital W, that means this capital W is nothing but small w into length of beam, correct? And that will be at the center of the beam. So that means to convert UDL into point load, we have to multiply the intensity of this load W, small w, into the length of this beam. Suppose this length of beam is L meter, M is unit. Okay, so this will be your quantity in the point load. So why I'm telling this? Because this, you will require this while solving the problems in this subject. In similar way, if I want to convert the UVL into point load, what I can do here? Suppose this is my beam. I want to convert this UVL into point load. Basically, what we have done here, while converting this small w into capital W, what we have done, we have multiplied this intensity to the length. Here, while converting triangular load or UVL into UDL, point load, it is simple to keep in mind that suppose this is again intensity is W kilonewton per meter. Now in case of this triangle, again you know that whole mass or weight is concentrated at CG, and you know that CG of this triangle, where it resides at, suppose this dark black point, I am representing that as a CG, that is center of gravity, correct? Now to convert this UL into the point load, first of all calculate the area of this triangle. Area is what? 1/2. Area of the triangle is 1/2 base into height. Here the base is what? This is base. Okay, remember that. I will show here. This distance is called as base here, and this is height. Okay, now here 1/2, days is small w into, because its maximum is intensity is w, small w into length it is. Okay, now this is your point load of UVL, but it will act, it will not act at the center as in the case of UDL. So this point load, this point load will act at this center of gravity, that is CG of this triangular area, and that CG is at what distance from the base? On base it is L by P, correct? I will remove this for the moment. L by 3 from the base and 2/3 of height from the apex. This is called apex. Keep in mind, this point is called apex. This point is called as apex. And this is base. Now this load, it will act at this. Okay, so this is the procedure how we convert this UDL and UVL into the point load. So the applications you will come to know while solving the problems, but you should know all these procedures without any ambiguity. Okay, so keep in this mind all those things you will very much needed in this subject, throughout this subject. Okay. These are types of loads we have seen. Before covering this free body diagram, I will discuss with you the types of supports, because that is actually needed. I will show you here the types of supports. Types of supports. Basically, there are to four main categories of supports, which is, first one is fixed support, second is roller support, third one is hinge, or this is also called pin, right? These are the basics, and one more we can say like a simply support, simple support. Okay, these are the supports. In fixed support, what happens? The end of the beam is fixed. Suppose this is a beam, so this end is fixed. And again, at the fixed support, we see we have three reactions. One is vertical reaction, another is a horizontal reaction, and one moment. In the case of roller support, suppose I am showing here like this way, roller. So this is roller support. At the roller support, we have only vertical vertical reaction and will there be any horizontal reaction? No, because it doesn't resist horizontal reaction or horizontal movement. There will be only vertical, and because it's rolling support will be having some moment. In the third is hinge. Hinge is basically is connecting two parts, or at this there is no moment at the hinge support. Okay, this moment will not be there. There will be only vertical and horizontal reaction. And at simple support, suppose this is a beam, and that support is that means it's only supports the beam, like the way the beam is simply kept over these supports. Okay, this is called as simple support of the beam. Okay, so this was the basics which were required. These 2 points, which are support, type of supports, and the existing reactions at all these supports. Another point was